I've reinstalled the changer back in the cabinet for one reason. I have it working, but for one reason it really was in the way and vulnerable in my workshop. So I got it working well enough. I think I was safe in putting it back in the cabinet. The radio and amplifier, of course, are still on my bench yet. I have to finish replacing paper wax capacitors in the radio. So basically, from the water damage, three of the suspension springs for the turntable, or the changer I should say, were completely rusted away. And VM Audio, Gary at VM Audio, sent me these replacements. And they fit just fine. So it's suspended correctly. Of course, when I got it, it was really out of kilter. Now, I didn't tighten up the double nuts or adjust it or anything, for the simple reason that I'm not sure if the radio will slide in with the changer in place, or if the radio has to slide in with the changer lifted up. I really believe that Magnavox made some engineering mistakes on how this thing mounts in the cabinet. I had to use a tool to route away some of the metal of the mounting plate that the changer goes on, so that part of the mechanism would easily pass. Otherwise, it was difficult to put this in and take it out. Now it's quite easy because I routed that metal away. And I've studied it. There's no other way it could go in but the way it is. So it's in the way the factory intended it to go. Once I get the radio and the amplifier back in, the speakers all back in, then I'm going to pull the TV out, the television out, and deal with that. I've replaced 22 paper wax capacitors and one mica mold paper capacitor that was right here where this orange drop is. And there are three mica molds. These are actually paper capacitors. They're molded paper capacitors. They test right on the money. And they're odd values. I'd have to parallel up a couple of capacitors to come up with the value of at least one of them. But they test okay, and I'm going to leave them in for now. Also, I have not replaced the four electrolytic capacitors, two in each can. Here's two, and here's two. I've decided they're running very cool. They test okay. So I'm going to leave those for now. If it's a mistake, I'll make sure that I make a video to point out that, yes, no matter what, you got to replace those. But anyhow, about the next step is to test the radio to make sure it still works after I replaced all those caps. So it's still working after I replaced all those parts.
Stock market volatility. Hi, Rick Ellen here. You can expect to see market volatility.
Some interference.
The financial startup out there. Look at it before I give anybody. Some organizations, you know, most of the money that you give them, they just spend to turn around and fundraise.
So I'm going to put it back in the cabinet. When I had the radio out on the bench, all four pilot lights were lit. I made sure they were, but not when I got it back in the cabinet. Three of them did not light. So I had to take the radio out. I didn't have all the woodwork that holds it in place, but I had to pull it out. And then there's an issue with this bracket on each side of the radio. Has a rubber toe that goes into a hole. And when you take this radio out and put it back in, these things move all over the place, and it pulls the rubber supports right out of this piece of metal. I'm sure there were 4 screws with washers and nuts on it originally. They weren't there when I got the radio. They were not there. So I put 4 screws, washers, nuts, and that solved that problem. This thing, I swear, this is almost a prototype, because things just don't seem to fit right, and I don't understand it. But anyways, and I can't get a Sam's manual for this entire piece. I've got Sam's manuals for the television. I've got riders for the radio and riders for the amplifier, but not this whole thing as a unit. And also, because of the way the record player seemed to fit down in there, I don't know. I'm confused. But anyways, the next thing that's confusing me, hopefully this is in the light enough, are these 2 pieces of decorative wood. Now this is in place. There's a slot up here, but you'll notice that it doesn't quite go all the way up into the slot. Things are not really square on this. Now these 2 pieces are supposed to go here, but look at how they look. I can't imagine that that's right. And of course, this fits all the way across, so these don't go down inside behind this. So I guess at this point what I'm doing is I'm cobbling it back together. I've got it closer to right than it was when I got it, but I know it's not completely right. It just isn't, but I'll do the best I can. Okay, one of the things with this Magnavox, you know, it was obviously very roughly treated by the original owners, and none of the screws match that put all this back together around the radio. So out of my collection, I got the closest thing I could find in bronze screws so that they won't stick out like say this screw would. I'll tell you, putting it back together was harder than rebuilding the amplifier and radio combined at this point. Okay, I've got these pieces in. My bronze screws that I found in my collection are a little longer than the original ones probably were, not too long, but I had to screw them in a little tighter. Now the next step is the radio pushes up against this, but you know I got this top piece off. And that's the part that's really confusing me, is how that goes in there. Now the radio is slightly crooked, and I have no idea how in the world they leveled it. If they adjusted the screws or the rubber mounts on it to pull it one side down tighter, maybe. The problem is, somebody else worked on this. And it was somebody that didn't know what they were doing. So that kind of work is they want to fix it, but what they do is they fix it so nobody can. So I'm trying to get this back together, and I feel that I'm cobbling it, but I'm doing the best I can. This piece clearly fits in a slot up there, but as you can see, it'll only go as far as that. So I think it doesn't go tight to the radio, so maybe there's supposed to be an open space. I have no idea. The radio is slightly crooked, but I'm not going to jump through hoops to try to straighten it out. I'm going to just put it back together as good as I can. Like I say, I wish I had the full service manual for this entire piece, but I've looked all over. I can't find one. So I'm doing the best I can. I'll put it together this way. All right, I got it in. The screws that I found in my collection sort of match, but they're not the right ones. I have no idea. You know, bronze screws are not easy to find. You can find brass screws in hardware stores, but I don't think you can find bronze ones, at least not like these. So from my stash, the screws I found worked the best, because like I say, the screws that the guy had in here were clearly wrong. So I'm getting closer to getting this thing back together. So it's all back together. I got the wires in, I think. I took pictures of it, so it's pretty close to what it was originally. This is a little, I got to tighten that screw, but it's the way it is originally, I'm pretty sure. Now, it's not going to get too much on FM because FM just terminates here. There's no internal FM antenna. But what I can do is get one of those dipoles that they used to provide with stereos in the 70s and put one of those on. This is the loop antenna for the AM radio. This antenna here, I kind of think is for a short wave, which I don't seem to get anything on short wave. I don't know, maybe there's maybe there's something wrong in the radio. I have no idea, but I'm not worried about short wave. But hopefully this thing should work now. That's hopefully it's going to work now. It's back in the cabinet. If it doesn't, well, the neighbors will hear me scream. This is my station. A little overmodulated. Let me turn the modulation down. Sounds pretty good. Let me put it on record player. Thank you. pretty nice. I'm gonna try a 33. I'm using the LP stylus. It's switched back here on this lever. By the way, this is the original stylus that was on here. I have a spare that I bought, but I'm not going to put it on just yet. It ended a little too soon. Let me... Maybe something's out of kilter. Oh, I hope I don't have to take this thing apart. It plays the 78s all the way. Yeah. Well, I don't know. Plays the 78s all the way through. Let me flip the record one. Let's give this one a whirl. Plays the 78s all the way into the center. Maybe it will if I, maybe just picking the arm up is just triggering it. I don't know. I'll watch it. We'll see what happens.